Hello everybody, today we want to give you a small presentation on KTC Medical Company Intercom Nurse Call System. As the name suggests, this type of nurse call system uses a two-way full duplex voice communication between the patient and the staff. So at first we want to introduce the elements of the management center. In the management center, first of all, we have the corridor display as you see it here. That shows the location of the initiated call, meaning the room and bed number of the patient that has initiated the call. And then in the management center, we have the staff console. As you see, a staff console also has one LCD that is used to show the location of the initiated call. And also it has some other buttons, some dedicated buttons, as you see. There is one button for talking to a patient. You can choose a patient using these keypads and then talk to the patient directly using the intercom panel. We have one button, dedicated button to announce it, to page an announcement in the ward. And then we have dedicated buttons to initiate an emergency code call. We have also dedicated buttons for critical bed assignment or to monitor the history or unfinished calls, the history of the calls. We have also some dedicated lamps, notification LED lamps, to notify the staff of any existing call, be it normal or emergency or other critical. So this is the elements of the management center. Now we want to explain the elements of the patient's console. As you see, we have two different sizes of two-way communication panel for the patient. They both have speakers, they both have dedicated adjustment, volume adjustment buttons, and they both have emergency call buttons, as you see. And they both have these jacks that connect to a coiled cord to a peer push button nurse call switch or a patient's handset. So on the peer push button, as you see, we have some back illuminated light that is that comes and goes, showing that the system is connected, and also to help the patient to find the peer push button in the night. And also it has the switch for study light for the patient and the microphone to be used in connection with the two-way communication panel. On the patient's handset, we have again the same system, like the turn off and on of study light. We have the nurse call, which is a normal, and also with the back illuminated light LED that shows the connectivity and also helps the patient to find the handset easily during the night. And then we have the membrane keypad to control the TV channels or radio. And then we have the 5mm jack for the headphone and also the speaker. So these are the elements of the patient's console. Then we go to the corridor or washroom elements. We have the overdoor corridor status lights, as you see here and here. And then we have the pull cord switch that is installed in the shower or in the washroom. By pulling this cord, the nurse call is initiated. And then we have the separate cancel panel or presence panel that the nurse should come and personally press. And this one is installed next to the door of the washroom or shower room. So to show you how this nurse call system functions, we will, for example, initiate a normal call first. And then on top of the normal call, we initiate one emergency call. And this shows you how priority is handled, priority of the calls is handled in this type of nurse call system. So first we go to bed number 2 in room number 1. This is bed number 2. For example, the patient presses the call button. As you see, bright red illumination is there activated for reassurance of the patient that the call has been initiated. And also the click of the button was another way to reassure him, to reassure the patient for the initiation of the call. And as you see in the over the door, the corridor status light changes the color to green, meaning that there is a normal call. From, as you see, the corridor display shows room number one, bed number two. So as we assume that at the same time, patient on bed number one initiates an emergency call. So here on the staff console, as you see, before we initiate the emergency call, we have room number one, bed number two, with a normal call, okay? So now I press the emergency button, emergency call button on bed number one, and we see what happens. So as you see, the chime, the acoustic chime changes, and the overdoor lamp also changes to blinking red, meaning that there is an emergency call. As you see, the display also overreads room number one, bed number two to room number one, bed number one, which means that this call has more priority, is higher in priority level. And then also the staff console shows room number one, bed number one, emergency. An emergency is blinking, meaning that the staff should pay attention to this call first. So now the nurse should go to room number one, bed number one, as it's shown everywhere. So imagine that the staff come, they do their job, and they press the presence. So after this is done, as you see, the overdoor lamp corridor status light changes to green again, meaning that the emergency is handled, and the display again shows room number one, bed number two, which is the room that is initiating a normal call. So then we should query. We should query the call, hello, hello. And then after querying the call, it is disappeared from the system, meaning that the call has been handled. So this is one example of how this system manages to handle different levels of the call. So finally, let's have a presentation of a service call. So if here somebody in the washroom pulls the cord, as you see, this is considered as a service call. And in the service call, again, we have the blinking red, which is not a normal call. And people should go, and staff should go and take care of the call. So this is the cancel presence button here on the next to the door of the shower. So by pressing this, the call is handled. So this is how the elements in this nurse call system act. And I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and have a nice day. Bye.